Okay, so our guest today was named one of the hottest Icelandic artists, and she supported the likes of Ed Sheeran, Banks, and she's joining us in the studio. It's Glowie.
Hey.
Hello. How are you?
I'm good. How are you?
Thank you for having me. It's all good, girl. I'm still here. I still care. When you feel alone and unlovable, lean on me.
Let's get straight into your journey and straight into you, all right? Now, I know that you were approached by many different record labels in the past, but you decided not to sign. What made you want to do that?
Well, it was at a time where I was very young and I didn't feel like I had really found my sound and honestly just wanted to gain more experience and grow up a little bit more and know more about myself as a person to be able to actually tell people who I am as an artist. I hadn't really found that, so just felt like it was the right decision.
You've openly spoke about your kind of childhood and being bullied in the past, and now, as an artist, you feel like you have a responsibility to be a role model to other young girls to speak out and just kind of stand up for themselves?
Yeah, definitely. I feel like just early on when I started to release music in Iceland, where I'm from, I had like a Snapchat account, which was like open to like my fans to follow what I was doing every day, and actually started to notice how many young girls were following me.
Wow.
And that's when I actually thought, like, wow, it's really important what I say because they're going to listen.
Definitely.
And I thought that was like a huge realization for me to actually use that platform for something positive to help them in any way. Yeah.
Well done. That's so cool.
Yeah. And I know you've supported the likes of Ed Sheeran and Banks.
Yeah.
How did that feel? And are there any other artists that you would like to collaborate with?
Well, it felt great. I mean, it's very overwhelming. I feel like everything's happening really fast. But at the same time, it was such a great experience, good learning experience. And yeah, I'd love to collaborate with all kinds of artists. I feel like my dream is to work with Alicia Keys.
Ooh.
I think she's like my favorite one.
Yes.
Yeah.
I see the braids, girl. We see it.
You see the hairstyle.
No, it makes it. I feel like you lot would make some sweet music together.
I've been to Reykjavik in Iceland, and I remember when I was beautiful, absolutely beautiful.
Yeah.
But I remember when I was over there. In terms of music, a lot of rock was being played. So I know that you are very much inspired by R&B. So how did your journey into, I guess, being an R&B inspired artist?
Yeah, we don't have a lot of R&B in Iceland. But I'm the youngest in my family, and I basically just like was introduced to music by my siblings and my parents, and they were really following like gospel artists and R&B and hip hop. Like, it really affected how I looked at music. Sometimes I can tell you acting like it's all fine,
all fine. Don't hide. Going forward, what are the future plans for you? What would you like to do?
I know it sounds a bit cheesy, but I like living in the moment. I don't like to like plan the future a bit too much or put too much like pressure on it or something like that. I like to have a few things that I'm focusing on.
So if I come to Iceland again, you show me where the R&B spots are at.
Don't forget me.
And you can come as well.
We actually like in the last 5 years, hip hop has been really big in Iceland.
Okay. Oh, nice. Yeah. So we definitely have to go.
Let's do it.
And you can be our official VIP escort.
Yes.
Because I know she's a plug.
She got no hookup.
You can get us in. Just be like, oh, we're with Glowie.
Yeah.
Cool, Glowie. I love it. Well, it's been an absolute pleasure having you on WhatsApp TV. Like, you are literally a glowy ray of sunlight. So thank you for dropping by.
Thank you so much. Thank you for having me.